I'm David Morrison. I'm the CEO of Integral Recyclers Limited.
My name is Tracy Ann Hyman, and I'm the CEO of Artel.
Hey, my name is Yakini Wallen-Bryan, CEO and founder of Prelabs Limited, and also winner of the Jay & Water Project Innovation Competition. I started Prelabs in 2016 after building our first prototype of a product to allow people to control their electrical appliances from their smartphone. Since then, we have a suite of products and services in which we can offer remote monitoring, control, and automation services for our consumer as well as business customers and clients.
I have been actually submitting this idea to competitions before, and it was not getting anywhere. But I felt deep down that the idea was workable, was viable. And I said, okay, come on, let's work this idea further. And I saw the JN opportunity. And but at that time, we had already reached a certain level in terms of the product and what it could do. And I thought, great, this is the perfect competition to enter. And we entered.
We decided to enter the competition because it synergizes what we were doing. We were already involved in the area of water management and water treatment. And then this was a perfect match for us, provided good exposure and also funding.
My name is Carlinton Burrell. I am the CEO of the Caribbean Climate Innovation Center, CCIC. So the Caribbean Climate Innovation Center was started in 2014 to support climate innovative entrepreneurs that have these brilliant solutions, and all they need was this intermediary entity to really help them to take these solutions to market. And so we provide entrepreneurial solutions such as business development, access to market, access to finance, access to technology. And along with that, we also provide grant funding, not just through our entity, but through our very key partners.
Due to climate change and a number of other factors, water security is one of the biggest problems facing Jamaica and the region right now and going into the future. We've used our technology and resources at Prelabs to develop a solution that allows consumers, business places, and entities across the board manage their water resources more sustainably and efficiently.
Well, when I look back over my life, I realize I've experienced quite a few disasters. I was actually in Japan for the 2011 Tohoku earthquake. I have been in the Bahamas for Hurricane Floyd, and also in Jamaica with the numerous hurricanes. So could you say that basically I was born to deal with disasters, but I'm not a disaster, right? So my inspiration came from working with communities all across the Caribbean in terms of the devastating impacts that flooding and disasters have had on communities. And so we came up with a flood planning tool because flooding is one of the most commonly occurring hazards within the Caribbean region.
I came up with the invention out of the need to find a cheaper protein source for people and for animals. And we were researching algae, producing algae as a byproduct of biogas production. And then boom, sargassum came, which was really an abundant supply of algae. 22 million metric tons passing through the Caribbean throughout the year. And we said that was it.
So across the country, we have seen a growing momentum to solve traditional water problems and emerging water problems. And so not just across the country, but if you look at the impact of the Jane Foundation and the work that they have been doing, and so the Caribbean Climate Innovation Center partnering with the Jane Foundation, we have seen a greater number of innovative adaptation solutions coming out of our partnership. So we see a lot of entrepreneurs emerging to the forefront and bringing forth their ideas, taking their ideas from ideas to prototype to commercialization as a result of a partnership with the Jane Foundation and the Caribbean Climate Innovation Center.
We decided to use sargassum because it's really an abundant supply of proteins which we can process or refine to be added to feed. To feed animals, people, so forth. If you go into an expensive Japanese restaurant, they have nori sheets. It's really still sargassum, it's just seaweed. So we decided to apply it here. It has never been done before, as far as we know, in this sector, in this area, in this region.
We came up with the idea. I went on a research exchange in North Carolina. We learned about this interesting modeling technique that's been around for about 15 or so years. We took that information and we put the pieces together. So basically what I've done is paired that solutions-oriented side of me with this particular problem to help to reduce lives lost and reduce the cost of flood damage on companies, businesses, governments, and communities all across the world.
We do this by allowing people to keep track of their water usage from their smartphone or their computer using an internet-enabled device. This device lets them know how much water they've used throughout the course of the day, week, or month, if they have a leak, and also allow them to shut off water from anywhere in the world from their smartphone or their computer. We also have a sensor that can let people know what level their water tank is from anywhere in the world.
Without this competition and the exposure it had and the funding, I would not have had the opportunity to employ persons already. We have two team members active on this project otherwise, employing four people overall. We have had the opportunity to do this, which was not possible without it.
The JN Water Project has allowed us to gather a lot of the resources that we need to develop and launch WaterPre on the best foot possible for the Jamaican market.
Well, the JN Climate Innovation Challenge has given us a lot of exposure as it relates to the tool. We've also got seed funds from Jamaica National. And importantly, I'm receiving mentorship from the Climate Change Innovation Center.
What we're seeing here is there's an opportunity. There's a company here that will help you, that will mold you, that will guide you, will give you all the necessary support you need from a business perspective to help to develop these solutions to, you know, so that they can be viable.
My father, who died when I was younger, had a passion for agriculture. And being one of two sons of his and also having a passion for agriculture, I mean, this very area we're in was where he did most of his work. It's near the Borders Research Center. I thought that it was important for me to carry on that torch or something that he would have wanted to be proud of.
Personally, I'm very passionate about the technology that we do and what we're doing here at Prelabs. And I'm always trying to find ways, along with my team, of how we can use our resources, our technology, and our insights to solve some of Jamaica's more critical problems.
One major contribution that I'd like to make, having gone through this competition and looking long term, I would love to introduce artificial intelligence into the flood disaster management process.
What I'd like to accomplish is this being the nucleus or the genesis of the integral group of companies where we provide green energy solutions, everything green, that can make the world a better place and show that we can make money, not harming the earth.
The thing is, Jamaica and the region in general has a lot of problems that no one else is trying to solve for us now. We understand these problems better than anyone else. So if we can develop a solution, if you believe in your solution and what you can do, go for it. Once it makes sense to you, put the pieces of the puzzle together. Just because no one has done it before doesn't mean that you can't do it.
To future green tech entrepreneurs, we say it's possible to be done. Keep pushing, keep at it. Follow your passion, follow your dreams, and simply make it happen.
You have to be determined. You have to be, focused on your goals and your dreams and going straight at it.
The CCIC and the JN Foundation has been having real impactful change, not just from an innovation perspective, but we have seen the involvement of the community and cultural change.
We at Prelabs would just like to thank the JN Foundation and the Water Project Initiative for giving us the ability to accelerate the development and commercialization of WaterPre. And we're only going to accomplish so much more. This is only the beginning.